So this film, Ravenous, pops up on my recently added and then begins to trend on Netflix. And because I've had quite a good experience with the Spanish language horror movie Veronica recently, I think, all right, give it a go. Before I get into it, you should know that Ravenous is a prize winner. It was awarded the accolade of Best Canadian Film at last year's Toronto International Film Festival. Somehow. I mean, what else was in competition? I should start making Canadian films. There's an opening there. Quick outline of the plot to begin with. Too many characters with exactly the same personality, and that's not a good personality, wander around post-apocalyptic Quebec having encounters with zombies of the 28 days later variety, except when they're not. And that's pretty much it. They knock around together, they get picked off one by one, and then the film ends. In between, there's some nice drone footage of Canadian forests and the odd caterpillar, but, you know, that aside, no plot. It's micro-budget, I get that. But the characters, they are all one note, glum. And they do that thing in movies that I hate. They never have the right conversations with each other. They never ask the kinds of questions that in real life, in that situation, you would ask. I had to look up their names afterwards because none of them stuck with me. Apparently the lead character, who looks exactly like Zane Lowe, that's a British DJ, he was called Bonin. The girl that he rescued, who was tied to the bed, was called Tanya. And there's also a little girl called Zoe, who knocks around with them. If the film had stuck with those three, then okay, it might have worked, but no. It has to introduce character after character after character. All of these random survivors who get chomped up 10 minutes after you meet them, and they're nearly all moody introverts. I'm telling you, the audition scene for this movie must have been to stand and look wistfully out at the horizon. I know it's hard to remain upbeat and cheery when everyone you know is now a blood-sucking monster and you've had to plug your own family, but come on, lighten up. There are attempts to mix things up tonally, and they're just bizarre. Zane Lowe cracks loads of jokes, and they're okay jokes. No one laughs. There's also this character dressed as a soldier who randomly shows up and tries to scare them. The third time he does this, he gets blasted by a shotgun. It's hilarious. No one cracks a smile. Everyone should have burst out laughing, even the guy on the floor with the great big bloody hole in his chest. How can a film about fast zombies be this slow? The start, it plods on and on and on and keeps making the same point over and over. I get it, we get it. They're brutalized. This is normal for them now. The blood, the killing, the murder. I get it, we get it. Now please, can the film just start? If you hate exposition, if you hate backstory or context of any kind, then trust me, this is the film for you. We get one or two details about each character, but nothing else. But the film's cardinal sin is how it portrays the zombies. They set these clever girl, velociraptor type traps. They lure victims in, they creep up on them quiet as ballerinas, and at other points they're running around like ravenous animals, wild beasts. You can't make them both Romero and Boyle zombies at the same time. You have to choose. You have to choose. This is tough getting to 10 chapters. The film's most striking image is this huge tower of chairs which our plucky survivors come across in the middle of a film. It's a very striking image. It's beautiful. Total nonsense. It doesn't make sense. The mechanics of it, how it fits in with the capabilities of the zombies. Don't tell me, oh Phil, it's supposed to be dreamlike. Nothing else in this film has that dreamlike aesthetic really. It just doesn't fit. Don't tell me, oh, it's allegorical, which I read online when I was having a look at some other reviews of this. Look, Romero did zombies gravitating towards the shopping centre 50 years ago. You know, that was true comment on society. If this film is about the modern state of Canada, then I need to sit the director down and tell him, mate, your film's not only boring, but also pretentious. just going to rattle through a few more complaints. These zombies are supposed to be ravenous, right? As in uncontrollably hungry. Well, a zombie at the end has a child right in front of him, completely defenseless, at his mercy, and he gets distracted by an accordion. An accordion. Is the accordion representing something else? Probably. But the film, this film, is not called Ravenous, and in brackets, unless someone's playing an accordion. Ah, I hated it. Second, the little girl Zoe walking off into the distance with a gigantic gun. No, stupid. She wouldn't be able to fire it. Third, throughout the whole film, we see that these creatures can hear the slightest snap of a twig miles and miles and miles away. And yet, the survivor who turns up at the end to save Zoe is in the loudest car of all time. Ah, only chapter 8. Did I mention the lead character looks like Zane Lowe? So much so that whilst I was watching Ravenous, I had an idea for a better movie. Zane Lowe trying to escape the BBC Live Lounge during a zombie apocalypse. You could have zombie Ed Sheeran, zombie Katy Perry, zombie Adele, all trying to get in and eat his brains. I'm telling you, that would be a better movie than Ravenous. Great soundtrack as well. Chapter 9. I've got nothing for Chapter 9. I'm just going to drink my tea, listen to the rain, think about my life. Feel free to do the same. Ravenous was bad. I don't know why Netflix bought the rights to distribute it. I don't know how it's got 88% on Rotten Tomatoes right now. At points it felt like the mid-season slump of a zombie show that's already been running for 8 seasons and run out of steam, run out of ideas, run out of budget. All of those things. This film is a zombie, dead behind the eyes, zoned out, occasionally nasty. The only time it came to life was when something ridiculous happened, like the moment when the smoke machine they were using broke down and the cast were literally drowned in dry ice, like at a 1990s disco. And, like a 1990s disco, Ravenous gets 2 out of 10. Runaway. Runaway fast.
Thanks for watching my video on Ravenous. Please subscribe for more great quality content, or no, let's just say content, about every other day on this channel. We're just getting started here, so really appreciate your support. Drop a like. If you disagree with me about Ravenous, stick it in the comments. I mean, no disrespect to the film, just wasn't my cup of blood. All right, guys, thank you.